since the campaign period for the September 11th parliamentary elections was formally opened yesterday after 5 p.m., this morning a number of Croatian parties launched their campaigns. The leaders of the Only Option Coalition, which mainly consists of several activist groups who form political parties, presented their platform in the eastern city of Vukovar. Members of the Coalition for Prime Minister, consisting of several parties but centered around Zagreb Mayor Milan Bandic, kicked off their campaign by talking about curricular and educational reforms. In the northern town of Čakovec, the leaders of the regional Međimurje Democratic Alliance place emphasis on the local economy, especially where this concerns the troubled textiles and footwear industries. The chairman of the National Elections Commission, Branko Hrvatin, commented on the case of commission member Milan Vresk, who, according to testimony he delivered to an Austrian court that was exclusively released by HRT, had allegedly received 210,000 euros for influence peddling in Croatia. Hrvatin insisted that Vresk is not participating in the commission's work because he is officially on sick leave, and that in any case the commission itself has no authority to decide on his case, as he was appointed by the Croatian parliament. The headquarters for the defense of Croatian Vukovar released a statement today on the yet again topical matter of dual script official public signs in the eastern city of Vukovar, on the heels of this weekend's claim by the interior minister that an audit of residency status claims by local Serbs would reveal that they do not have sufficient numbers to merit the official use of their language and script in the city. The headquarters asserted that their percentage of the population is irrelevant, citing a provision of the Constitutional Minority Rights Act that any exercise of minority rights must also be applied with due respect for the rights of the Croatian people as well. Just before 10 a.m., an earthquake was registered with its epicenter 5 kilometers east of Posušje in neighboring Bosnia-Herzegovina. It had a magnitude of 3.2 on the Richter scale and could be felt in and around the nearby Croatian town of Imotski. In sports, in Olympic action, Croatian discus thrower Sandra Perković, the reigning Olympic and European champion, qualified for the finals in this event. She will be defending her title later today. The Croatian men's handball team defeated Tunisia 41-26, thus finishing first in their group. They will face Poland in the quarterfinals on Thursday. The men's basketball team also secured a win, defeating Lithuania 90-81, thus also finishing first in their group. They will face Serbia in the quarterfinals also on Thursday. Later today, the men's laser class sailing race, which was postponed yesterday due to bad weather, will be held. Croatia's Tonči Stipanović, already well-placed in terms of points, is hoping for the gold medal. Ivan Kljaković-Gašpić is also in the running for a medal in the Finn class. In other events, the Croatian men's water polo team is facing Brazil in the quarterfinals of that tournament, while in boxing, Croatia's Filip Hrgović will go against Cuba's Lenir Pero in an attempt to make it to the semifinals in the super heavyweight category. And finally, the weather forecast for the rest of the day. Sunshine will alternate with overcast skies inland, accompanied by a chance of scattered showers with thunder, mostly in the northwest, but also possibly in the western mountain zone and on the northern coast. Skies will be mostly sunny in Dalmatia. Moderate southwesterly and westerly winds will blow on the coast, while northwesterly winds will blow in the open waters. Today's high temperatures range from 24 to 29 degrees Celsius inland and from 28 to 33 degrees on the coast and adjacent areas. Conditions will be similar in the interior over the next 3 days, meaning unstable with occasionally overcast skies accompanied by rainfall and even thunder. More sunshine is expected on Friday. Temperatures will be similar to today's or possibly just a little lower. Sunshine and very warm to hot conditions will prevail on the coast, albeit with the possibility of minor local bouts of stormy weather in the north. There will be more clouds in Dalmatia on Wednesday, although with only a slight chance of showers. Moderate southwesterly and westerly winds can be expected in the afternoons, with southeasterly winds at places at the end of Wednesday and into Thursday.